geography content program, we are now talking about biogeography. Biogeography derives itself from ecology, we all are aware of it, and it makes an important part of your general studies 3 in main, as well as it is an important topic of your general studies prelims, environment, ecology, biodiversity, climate change. In our optional, we definitely have to divide it into two, in paper 1 and in paper 2. So we are taking it as focus of paper 1, where you have to deal up with fundamentals of ecology, identifying vegetation, etc. And if you see the question trend, we have encountered question on a successive sequence on the fundamental principles of ecology mostly. I have regularity of the questions that have come up from the other heads like biome, vegetation, soil. Soil and ecological aspects have been more prominent. So in this GCP session, I want to talk about the fundamental of ecology, environmental gradient as the previous year question, and how to frame up the answer so that you can take up the content specification to the biogeographical content. So let us get on to our readymade answer to the PYQs to understand how to work. As you can notice, I have selected two PYQs here. It is 2022 question, plants and animals that exist in a particular ecosystem are those that have been successful in adjusting to their habitat and environmental conditions. Elucidate with examples. And we have 2019 question. It is something more specific that has been asked. Amensalism is the biotic factor that determines the geographical limit of the species, explained. In both these questions, what has been the common thing for all of us to highlight? So I have given you that frame. So just scroll it up and make you understand it. Can we notice that in both the questions, we need to talk about determiners of habitat, environmental gradient. Amensalism is a biotic factor, we do understand. But is biotic factor not regulated by environmental gradient? So in both the questions, you need to talk about environmental gradient and then the adaptation. So coverage of all aspects of adaptation by plants and animals with natural selection has to be taken up. Then I have specified 2019 question is more specific, which talks about the biotic interactive relation. Though in both the questions we have to involve environment, thus we are creating different answers to both the questions. There is a compulsion for us to follow that whenever you are trying to chart out the answer, it has to be as per what was the demand that was put forth in front of us as a question. Amensalism do takes into reference environmental gradient, but it will not be covering the complete physical aspects related to it. And that is the reason when you are trying to create out the answer, you are required to take into consideration specification in both the cases. So two different answers, one by one. Beginning with 2020, I have started the answer with what is ecology? Ecology deals with the ways in which organisms are molded by their surrounding and molds them, because it's a mutualistic relation. Because when you have to talk about ecosystem where plants and animals have adapted to their surrounding, you have to begin up with that interactive link. So very minimal kind of an introductory line, and after that you have to take up the reference of environmental conditions. And when I take environmental conditions, do take into reference limiting factor, which is correlated very clearly with environment determining the success of species. It may be abiotic or biotic. When I take up the reference of example, amount of grass available as food for grazing animal or salinity for oceanic or aquatic animal. So my limiting factor can correlate with the physical environment, and it is also combined with this habitat and niche. Because as soon as you take into reference a niche, you have created biotic component associated with it. So in 2022 question, you have to create out all those dimensions. Habitat is what I occupy. Niche is what is the role that I play. I do understand that niche incorporate nth factor dimensions. And that is what we have taken up in reference here. Everything affected by organism during its lifetime. And after talking about this, you have to take the reference of natural selection, which I have marked the beginning here. And then we have added
because it's a limited scope. So support of a flowchart. Support of the flowchart gives me again a very prominent justification of adaptation, because you need to interpret that natural selection is where environment favors adaptations preventing extinction, which is driven by genetic variation resulting in divergence and leading to specifications. You have to take understanding that I survive because I adapt myself to the certain condition. So the gist of the question is being perfectly answered here. But can I pause down with my answer at this level? No, you have to talk about the further factors. Natural selection, 5 pointers must come up in your answer, because that is what leads to the specifications and adaptations. This is 2022. You can cite multiple examples with each one of them. You can take reference of Urey and Steno organism, but because we have attempted 2 answers, I avoided talking about that in this answer. And then comes in amensalism. When we begin the answer of amensalism, we can start by referring that amensalism is one of the biotic-biotic interaction. But what facilitates that biotic-biotic interaction? That is the reason I insisted that when we take up the reference of amensalism, you must start with species range is a geographical area where a particular species live. It essentially includes the area where individuals migrate or hibernate as well. Because if I don't take into consideration the multiple constituents that are associated with a particular habitat, I won't be in the position of generating out biotic-biotic links. So a general introductory factor. Then you have to talk about the species variation as cosmopolitan and endemic. And here comes my environmental gradient. इस डायग्राम के बिना आप दोनों में से कोई आंसर को कंप्लीट नहीं मान सकते हो. When I say दोनों में से कोई आंसर को कंप्लीट नहीं मान सकते हो, because you have to justify that environmental gradient if is very low, individuals will be absent because it is intolerant zone. Environmental gradient is immensely high, again the individuals will be absent. It is optimum zone where you have got abundance of individuals. But this abundance of individual is single niche excess. Organisms don't survive in isolation. They have other organisms that facilitate, interfere their existence. And amensalism gives you that kind of factor. So as soon as you have created this diagram, single niche excess, you have to get to biotic community, competition, symbiosis, and amensalism. Be very cautious of how it is going on. First and foremost, amensalism interaction, species causing harm produces chemical or other product as normal working or defensive strategy that negatively impact other species. Because what is amensalism? Amensalism is that type of interactive relation where one is neutral and other suffers the negative outcome. This is how you distinguish it. आपके answer में यहाँ पर multiple excess niche को बनाना बहुत जरूरी है. और जब आप multiple excess niche को बना रहे हो, when you are talking about what is the difference between fundamental and realized niche, you have to understand that you have to talk about the niches diversity which I have written up here. Spatial, trophic and hyper volume. Because if I am a weaker specimen, I will fail to occupy the entire niche. I'll be only occupying the area where I can adjust and survive. So my realized niche will be weaker than my fundamental niche. In comparison, the specimen that has got stronger or adaptive characteristics will have its fundamental and realized niche to be the same. यहीं पर ही तो आपका बायोटिक बायोटिक रिलेशन एज कॉम्पिटिशन और बायोटिक बायोटिक रिलेशन एज अमेंसलिज्म मार्क्स अप इट्स फैक्टर. सो अमेंसलिज्म के कंटेंट को आप ऐसे बिल्ड करेंगे और उसके बाद आप लेकर जाएंगे अमेंसलिज्म के टाइप्स पर. अमेंसलिज्म के टाइप्स में आप एक तो इंक्लूड करते हो कॉम्पिटिशन और दूसरा इंक्लूड करते हो एंटीबायोसिस. Competition, we all know Gauss's principle of competitive exclusion, where one will be adjusting, as I've told you, with the multiple dual dimension niche. One will be adjusting because it is having lesser capacity, and two will be occupying the bigger range. जो antibiosis है वो बड़ा interesting point है. Competition का example दिया है, negative interaction है. Goat and grasshopper का example जो हमने diagram में बनाया. Antibiosis जो है ये बड़ा interesting point है, ये largely students miss out कर देते हैं. When I talk about antibiosis, in antagonistic relation of amensalism between the species colonizing similar ecological niche, spatial niche. आप निच के बिना इस आंसर को क्रिएट ही नहीं कर सकते, यही बात हम आपको समझा रहे हैं. यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट वन ऑर्गेनिज्म प्रोड्यूसेस एंटीबायोटिक एज फॉर्म ऑफ डिफेंसिव मैकेनिज्म, एंड दिस इज वेयर वी हैव पेंसिलिनियम एंड बैक्टीरिया एज द प्रोमिनेंट एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर अस टू अप्लाई. बिकॉज वेन यू ट्राई टू टेक अप द रेफरेंस ऑफ दीज कंस्टिट्यूएंट्स, यू टेक इन टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट वन इज डूइंग इट टू इट्स सर्वाइवल. It is neutral about the other, but other is suffering because that defensive mechanism is interrupting its existence. Answer writing skills involves not just the requirement of formatting, it is also the sequential flow of the information. You have to be in a very consistent brainstorming. You have to keep your thought process into the grinding. It should be in the circular motion. It should always be in the utilization, and that comes up with practice. I have always been there. आप थक जाओगे पर हम नहीं थकेंगे बोलते हुए. Shortcuts के लिए कभी भी मत भागना. आप बहुत confident हो अपने understanding of the content से, simply take reference of PYQ, solve करो उनको. Solve करते हुए ही आपको पता चलेगा कि am I in the position of creating out the logical content? क्या मैंने question के key pointers को पकड़ा था कि नहीं? क्योंकि जो आपका पहला क्वेश्चन हमारा है 2022 का, इसमें मैक्सिमम स्टूडेंट्स जब आंसर लिखते हैं तो उनका पूरा का पूरा फोकस वन बायोम टू अदर बायोम टू थर्ड बायोम, माने क्वेश्चन क्या बन गया, एग्जांपल्स बन गया, कंटेंट नहीं आया. एग्जांपल साइट करिए लेकिन आंसर भी तो दीजिए. सो दैट इज द पॉइंट दैट वंस यू टेक द राइटिंग टू योर स्ट्राइड, यू अंडरस्टैंड वेयर एग्जैक्टली यू नीड टू वर्क. दैट इज द लॉजिक ऑफ GCP. So I'm very thankful to all of you in showing so much of interest with it. I'm right there. I'm eager to work more hard, write more answers to help you out. So take reference of this also. Class notes का PDF भी इसके साथ अटैच किया है, उसके साथ इंटीग्रेट करके, क्योंकि हम फंडामेंटल और रियलाइज निच को एक अलग तरीके से पढ़ते हैं. आप उसको कंबाइन करें, आपका कंटेंट बिल्डिंग अपने आप ही पूरा हो. बाय बाय फ्रॉम माय साइड.